This week, San Jose State returns to CEFQ Stadium to host the University of New Mexico in a Mountain West contest. Friday night, October the 4th, 7:02 p.m. Game will be televised by the CBS Sports Network. You can also hear the game on the Spartan Radio Network with the KKSF 910 Real Talk as the flagship station, also on Sirius XM Radio. We have various promotions this week here for Friday night's game. There's a Brew and Vine promotion. It's also parent and family weekend night. Plenty of tickets are available through 924-7589 and the 408 area code, or by going on sgsuspartans.com. It's now time to bring in San Jose State football head coach, Brent Brennan.
Lawrence always does such a good job with the introduction. That was fun. Thank you for coming. We are glad to be coming back to CEFQ Stadium this week and be in front of our fans and our student body and be on our home turf. So we're excited about that. Congratulations Air Force. They are a very good football team. And I was really impressed with just how well they executed their scheme. And obviously it was a hard fought game. I thought our team played extremely hard, but we didn't make enough plays on either side of the ball. We had the multiple fourth down opportunities that I chose to go for, thinking that we were going to need to score touchdowns and not field goals. And when we didn't convert, it got out of hand. So, but I think that Air Force team is really good. I think they're going to win a lot of games. I was impressed with their team and the product they put on the field. But shifting gears to New Mexico, we got a team coming in here kind of like us. They're 2-2. They've got a bunch of good players across the board. I think, they got a veteran offensive line. They've been a little bit of both. They've thrown for a ton of yards. They've run for a ton of yards. So it's hard to know what exactly to expect that way. They have a really active defense. Their linebackers, I really like their front seven. I think their linebackers really run and hit. They do a great job bringing those linebackers in pressure. And then in the back end, they got guys that can really run and cover. So this is going to be a really good battle Friday night. We have a good football team coming in here. I don't know if Coach Davey's back on the sideline this week. I heard he might be, so I think that would be it'd be good to see him. And we're looking forward, like I said, we're looking forward to being home and playing New Mexico Friday night in front of our students and our family and our friends.
Hey, Coach. Nick Nash is now receiving for you guys at the same time. Can you explain his versatility? How has he improved you guys' offense so far?
Well, Nick's just been a great addition, I think, this season. A lot of the stuff that we saw him do in practice, he's been able to do in games, which is fun. His ability to run and throw and catch, makes it kind of a slash type situation where, some of you are probably too young to remember Cordell Stewart, but, when he was playing for Pittsburgh, they did all kinds of stuff with him, and that's what Nick's kind of doing for us, and I think he gives us something offensively that's fun, and it's fun to scheme up and see if we can get him the ball and give him a chance to make plays.
Coach, the first time in nearly a month to get home and play in front of the home crowd. How excited are you and the guys to, get back on the home field?
Well, we've had a great week of practice so far. I'm excited about that. Obviously, we've been dealing with a little bit of a funky schedule with an early bye, Thursday game to start the season, early bye, then back-to-back road games and a short week. And so we're just looking for that to kind of level out. And, there's no place like home. We love playing here. We had a good crowd when we played Tulsa in Northern Colorado, and I thought our fans really impacted the game. So I'm excited to be here with our band and our students. And, we had all the student athletes here at our last game just going crazy, getting the student section riled up. So we're excited to be home.
Brent, Josh Love's had a really strong start to the year. What are some of the things he does really well?
I think we're all excited about Josh and how he's playing. I think he's doing a great job, just executing the offense. I think I've mentioned it before, but this is the first time that he has had a the same offensive coordinator for two seasons in a row in his career, and you can kind of see that his consistency and his decision-making improving with that. Like I've mentioned also, I think Ryan Gunderson's doing a great job coaching him and getting Josh just everything he needs, you know, to prepare and execute. And then on top of that, Josh is really an invested it's a crazy amount of time. He really wants to be a good player. And I think that's what the quarterback position has to do. I think it's the toughest position to play in all of sport. And if you don't know everything you can possibly know going into a game, it's hard to play at a high level. And Josh has really invested his time and spends a ton of time in the film room and a ton of time asking questions and talking with, you know, both his position coach and our offensive coordinator about, you know, what he can expect to see. He's in the O-line room with our O-line coach talking about pressures and protections. He just really, I think a combination of all those things has led to his high level of execution.
Coach, we're going to go to the phone, and Steve Vigren of the Albuquerque Journal has a question for you. Steve, go ahead.
Yeah, well, you know, I think that, you know, we've both taken turns playing well this season and then, you know, not playing our best football. But I also think that, you know, they've got a veteran group in the offensive front, and so do we. You know, I think their bodies look similar to ours at some positions. Defensively, they do they're a lot of movement and, you know, some pressure. And so I think just there's, you know, the teams kind of seem to match up pretty good that way to me in terms of the bodies. That they've got playmakers at wide receiver and quarterback. You know, their tight end's a good player, which I think we have some of those similar things also. So I just think there's some real similarities between our two teams that's going to make for an exciting matchup Friday night. Yep.
Hey, Coach, you got back-to-back Friday games. What is it like playing Friday night again all over again? Did anything change from last week to this week?
Just at least I think the biggest difference is we have an extra day this week. You know, last week we got back at 5 in the morning and, you know, we were getting ready for a Friday game. So it felt short, and obviously we grinded through it, but it was just that part of it felt a little bit rushed. And, you know, when you compress a week like that, you're just trying to do all the prep and all the work you can do to prepare for your opponent. And it definitely ends up feeling a little bit rushed. Even though you're putting in an insane amount of man hours trying to get it right.
Coach, backtracking a little bit to last week, although the final result wasn't what you guys wanted, what are some positives that you can relay to the team, or that you did relay to the team coming out of that game?
Well, I thought we played extremely hard, you know, and I think, you know, if we're going to be the kind of football team we want to be, we have to play with an extreme level of high effort. And I thought that was visible in that game. You know, I think there's always those things that you point to in a game, you know, if this, then that. And there was a lot of those situations in that game, you know, if we convert on this fourth down, if we get this call, if we, you know. But what I've told our team is that, you know, we can't change our past. And all we can focus on is right now and getting ready for this game Friday night. So that's been our conversation since we got back from Air Force.
Coach, we'll go back to the phone. And Steve, another question for Coach Brennan.
I'm good. I'm good.
Okay.
Coach, back to Josh Love. 11 receivers against Air Force, 10 against Northern Colorado. I believe he had 9 against Arkansas. He's sharing the wealth amongst his receivers. What do you go with his growth from that, and also with Coach Cummins and Coach Gunderson with the teaching of them?
No, I think that's been a real positive. I think if, as an offense, if we get too focused on throwing the ball to certain people, you know, you can get one-dimensional, right? And we want to be able to spread the field. We want to be able to have good distribution with the football. And I think it's important for everyone to know that when they're running those routes, or, you know, that they have to be full speed, they have to be detailed, they have to be at the right depth, they have to have the proper spacing, because Josh is going to find them if his progression takes him there. So, that part of it, I think, is great. I think that, speaks to, you know, our progress offensively, is that we're distributing the ball really effectively. And even in the game against Air Force, right, like, we had great sustainable drives that we didn't finish. And, you know, that's been a huge discussion the last 48 hours is okay, we're in all these situations in the red zone. We have a great, you know, 70-yard drive, 60-yard drive, 55-yard drive, 80-yard drive, and then we don't make the play in the red zone when we need to. So I think that's all about capitalizing on those moments when we get the opportunity to do that.
It seems like we touch on this almost every week, but San Jose State's continuing to make strides, positive strides, in the turnover margin area. Touch a little bit about kind of what you saw in the Air Force game and how your team continues to improve in that side of the ball.
No, I was really excited about that. I think a lot of people are going to talk to the glaring turnover we had on the kickoff return, and that's just a really that's a really hard play. The wind switched, you know, in between the quarters there, and it was blowing really, really hard, and we tried to move those – our returner's up, and that ball hit with really good hang, and it pushed back towards the other end zone. And so obviously it was a costly turnover when it happened, but our defense had a couple takeaways, which was really, really positive, especially against a team like Air Force, who does a nice job with the football. So I firmly believe if we continue to make great strides in the turnover margin, we're going to end up on the good side of the win column. It's such an important thing, and so I'm proud of how we're taking care of the football as an offense. It can still be better, absolutely can be better, but I think the defense and their mentality about going after the ball and making plays when they have a chance to has been extremely positive. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach. We'll look forward to seeing you again here next week. Reminder that this week, it's San Jose State in New Mexico. Friday, October the 4th, at CEFQ Stadium, 7:02 p.m. Tickets are available. We look forward to seeing you. And if not, we will see you next time here for the San Jose State University Football News Conference.